What are the layers of Earth? Do you ever wonder what's beneath your feet? How deep does the Earth go? It may seem like the Earth is made up of one big solid rock, but it's not. Throughout Earth's history, it has gone through many changes that have led to the formation of four distinct layers, stacked like the layers of a yummy cake. If you were to slice into the Earth, you would find the crust, the mantle, the outer core, and the inner core. The crust is the part we live on. It is the relatively thin, rocky outer skin. It's made of rocks, mountains, oceans, and even continents. But guess what? If the Earth was an apple, the crust would only be as thick as the apple skin. Scientists distinguish between two fundamentally different types of crust: oceanic crust, which composes the ocean floor, and continental crust, which makes up continents. Oceanic crust is covered by a layer of sediment made of clay and tiny shells. Unlike oceanic crust, continental crust is made up of many different types of rocks. On average, continental crust has a granite-like composition. Tectonic plates, large pieces of both types of crust, fit together like a jigsaw puzzle. They usually move along slowly, no more than a couple of inches per year. They collide to build mountains or break apart to form new seafloor. Earthquakes and volcanic activity also happen because of movement along plate boundaries. These plates float along the next layer, the mantle. It makes up an estimated 70% of the Earth's mass and a whopping 85% of its volume. This layer is super hot. The mantle is made of molten rock called magma. Do you know the difference between magma and lava, like what spits out of a volcano? It's pretty simple. Both lava and magma are from superheated rock that basically becomes gooey. Magma is molten rock still located within the Earth. When magma reaches the surface and erupts from a volcano, it officially becomes lava. So the only difference is where you find it. The mantle is 1,800 miles thick and is made up of a rock called peridotite. Although rare at the Earth's surface, it's actually the most abundant rock on our planet. Next comes the outer core. This part is made of super hot liquid metal, mostly iron and nickel. When the liquid iron of the outer core circulates around the solid iron of the inner core, a magnetic field forms. This magnetic field protects the planet from the sun's solar radiation. Researchers have never sampled the planet's mantle or core directly, but they analyze seismic waves from earthquakes to figure out the composition of Earth, looking at how the waves of energy change speed, bend, and get reflected as they move through the different layers. The fourth and final layer of the Earth is the inner core. Even though it's almost as hot as the sun, the inner core is solid because of all the pressure pushing on it. It's like a giant metal ball, mostly made of iron. The inner core has a radius that is about the same as our moon, 746 miles. Scientists think the inner core spins slightly faster than the Earth does. And that's our journey through the four layers of the Earth. The crust is where we live and where the continents and oceans are. The mantle is where the majority of Earth's volume is. The outer core is made of flowing liquid metal that helps create our magnetic field. And the inner core is a solid metal ball